Hello, I'm the Nostalgia Critic. I remember it, so you don't have to. Well, it's after Christmas again, and once again, I can't help but feel the post-Christmas blues. I mean, all this time waiting for Santa to bring me something wonderful and fantastic, these really great presents. And what does he bring me? PlayStation 3 Entertainment System, a brand new controller, a controller for the Blu-ray player, Soul Calibur 4, and no Batman Arkham Asylum. What have I done, Santa? What have I done to deserve such torture? Instead, what did I get instead of Batman Arkham Asylum? Ernest Saves Christmas. Ernest Saves Crap! Just show it. Ernest, played by the late Jim Varney, is one of those movie characters that somehow I've overlooked. And granted, he's not a terrible character.
Santa! Are you in there?
Well, not that terrible. He's mostly just irritatingly annoying. But still, after a whopping 13 movies spread out between theatrical, TV, and VHS releases, it's pretty hard not to take a look at him. For those who don't know, Ernest got his start as a commercial spokesperson. For what, you may ask? Well, everything.
Peppermint stick ice cream?
Cream Weber Highland cottage cheese.
Miller Yellow Tyson's Toyota.
And also don't forget to buy Citizen Penguin, the only penguin that has the voice of Orson Welles.
I'm doing this voice under protest.
Neat, huh? So because of his popularity, they finally gave him a movie called Ernest Goes to Camp. It was stupid, but not Christmas-oriented. So instead, we're gonna take a look at the sequel, Ernest Saves Christmas. So, let's see why... Let's just see why. So the film is apparently so cheap that it relies on old Coca-Cola ad for its opening credits. Now, I have to admit, this actually is kind of a nice opening, but seriously, would anyone ever connect this to an Ernest movie? It's kind of misleading. I mean, the credits say a lot about a film. I mean, it's kind of like starting off a movie like this.
The world is changed. I feel it in the water. Much that once was is lost, for none now live who remember it.
See? Doesn't add up. But actually, the movie has another thing going for it. It has probably one of the best Santa Clauses of all time. He's played by Douglas Seal, who you may remember as the Sultan from Aladdin. And I swear, you've never heard a kinder puppy dog of a human being in your life.
You know, I've carried this torch for more seasons than I should have done. Because I loved it so much. But now, taken to making notes. Well, you can't do it that way. It shouldn't be done that way. It can't be done that way.
I believe. But even he falls victim to some lame setups. Like, just count how many Santa puns there are here.
First time in Orlando?
Oh, no. I fly in once a year.
Where are you from?
Up north.
Me too. What line of work you in?
Toys, mostly.
No fooling. You been in it long?
Longer than you can imagine.
Oh, I hear that. A lot of contacts.
Oh, all over the world. Yes, I'm used to a colder climate myself.
Ah, great! You blew up the... Santa pun-meter. Why do I have one of those?
Oh, Christmas tree.
And there's Obnoxious Maximus himself, driving some poor schmuck to the airport.
Hey, buddy, hurry up. I gotta get to the airport.
Oh, don't worry, mister. We'll make that plane. Thrill driver!
Hey, welcome to Crazy Taxi. You gotta get your comic foil to the airport in under 5 crazy minutes. Oh no, your passenger fell out of the car. Now start mugging to the camera because the director thinks it's funny.
Meanwhile, Santa has a little trouble getting through customs.
Is this your real name?
It's the name I'm known by, yes.
Sure.
Hey, as long as your name's not Muhammad, you're good.
Thanks, Skippy.
It's Vanessa, thank you.
Hey, you better go faster. You have only 30 seconds to get your passenger on the plane to mine school. And how about some more close-up buggy? Way to go! Your next passenger should probably be a supporting character.
Taxi! Mister, I'm a taxi, I'm a taxi!
Don't forget to hit the Asians! Now, finish off with some more buggy.
Crazy.
So Ernest P. Worrell drives Santa Claus around in a cab. Boy, that's something I didn't think I'd say today. As they make some playful chit-chat.
Sun getting to you?
Oh yes, it's not as bright at night. I'm usually here at night.
Wait a minute, what did that bumper sticker say? So Ernest wants to keep the Christ in Christmas even though he's in a movie about Santa Claus. Yeah, hold on a second.
This is the movie.
Hello! Meanwhile, we cut to these two guys who are looking after Santa's cargo at the airport.
What is that, M?
V.
No, right here. That's an M.
V.
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 M.
V. M. V. M. V. M. V. M. V. M. V. M. V. M. V. M. V. M. V. M. That's my gimmick, folks. The eyes. It ain't much, but you can't do it. After that, we cut to some chick who got lost in the 80s as she tries to run away from paying a restaurant bill and gets into Ernest's cab.
You see that guy back there? That's my mean uncle. He's making me work in that restaurant like a slave. He keeps me locked up in the basement where there's rats and...
He'll sit on a throne of lies.
So please don't let him get me, okay?
You're safe with us.
Thanks. I'm Harmony Starr. Remember that name, because I'm going to be famous someday.
Yes, I bet it will be.
Oh, this is Ernest. I'm Santa Claus.
Call the police.
So he drops Santa off at the Children's Museum as he goes in to find a man named Joe Struthers, who he's hoping will take over the role as Santa for him.
I'm the greatest. Rah! Oh, me too, me too. Rah!
Wow, the effects of Avatar aren't as good as I thought they'd be.
And that's why we don't see dinosaurs around anymore.
Wait a minute, what? Years of inconclusive research about what killed the dinosaurs and all this time the answer was in the head of a bad children's puppeteer? How come nobody tells me these things?
Hello, do I know you?
Yes, you do. Your name was originally on a list with several hundred others. Slowly, for one reason or another, the other names were eliminated.
Whoa! Santa's got mob ties!
I broke their merry little thumbs and shoved them down the Yuletide elevator shaft. Don't make me do that to you, Joe.
But now I'm sure I have the right man for the job.
Job? What job? What is this all about?
Joe! You are going to be the new...
Adolf Hitler!
This is it, Joey. The hand of fate is reaching out to you. Holiday flick called Christmas Slave.
Hey, it's that guy from No Reservations.
Blake Farrell had the lead. At the last minute, he goes skiing, falls flat on his puss, wrecks up a $5,000 nose job just like that. Do you love it? I love it. Yes. Talk about
Don't make me add you to my list.
I want you to tint your hair and lose the beard.
No, Joe. No.
Who is this guy? Already, I don't like him a lot.
How ironic. That's what most people say when they watch No Reservations.
My name is Santa.
Excuse me, Mr. Santos. We're having a conversation. May we continue, please?
My goodness. My sack.
Yeah. If an old man ever shouts in the middle of a conversation, my sack, it's probably best just to run away. So he realizes he left his bag of toys at Ernest's cab. Meanwhile, Joe's agent tries to keep both Santa and Joe away from each other.
I'm Marty Brock. I'm Joe's agent. So, Mr. Santos, you live around here?
No. I have to go and find Joe. Excuse me.
What about now, Mr. Santos?
The name is Santa Claus.
I love the way he says that line. It is so deadpan serious.
The name is Santa Claus.
It almost sounds like a Schwarzenegger line or a Stallone line, doesn't it? I mean, it's just so badass.
The name is
Santa Claus.
You know what? I want to hear that line just before an action movie starts.
What about now, Mr. Santos?
The name is Santa Claus.
Sadly, admitting his true identity doesn't work out quite well.
I'm just looking for my sack. It's big, red, and tied up with string. Why won't you help me find my sack?
Meanwhile, Ernest heads over to a friend named Vern's house to drop off a Christmas tree. I guess he sort of adopted this 80s chick as well.
Ho, 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 Vern! Merry...
Wow, I think the movie just rejected him.
It's Santa's little party, helper.
Hi!
This is Harmony. She's been having kind of a tough time, so I'm helping her out.
Now, as you may have guessed, we never actually see Vern, which is a little weird. I mean, is he just filming everything that Ernest is doing right now? What's that, Vern? You filming this for court? Pictorial evidence? Cool! Yeah, when does Vern drop the camera and start pummeling the hell out of Ernest, anyway?
As the twig is bent, so grows the tree. Know what I mean? It'll look good right over here. Vern, I'll make it fit.
So Ernest goes back to the car and decides he wants to take a look into Santa's bag.
Zool, motherfucker! Zool!
Okay, he doesn't see that, but he does realize that the guy really is Santa Claus. He tries to give the bag back to him at the Children's Museum.
Are you in there? I've got your sack. It's safe.
I told you, they're all gone.
Nah, I guess we'll just have to find another camera to make faces into, preferably wide-angle lens.
Watch this.
Help! Santa entrapped our souls!
He eliminated us from his list! He's evil!
So it turns out the toys start off as glowing spheres and transform into goodies. But nobody knows how to get exactly the right toys except for Claus himself. And he's not doing very well right now.
But you'd be an awful lot better if you give me a real name. I've told you. I've told everybody. My name is Santa Claus.
All right, knock it off!
You and me got some paperwork to do.
You're making a very big mistake.
Hey, look at this. I never saw anything like this before.
Apparently, he also has acid for blood. We then cut to Ernest's house, who I swear to God just got out on loan from Pee-wee's Big Adventure. Now, no. It's another morning I wake up with a 16-year-old girl on my couch.
It's time to put fuel in the tank and rubber on the road and reunite old Father Christmas, a close, personal friend of mine, with his magic sack.
Will you stop talking about his sack?
One Christmas Eve, I was lying in bed, and I thought I heard a noise in the heat ducts.
And you thought it was reindeer on the roof?
No, I thought it was Santa Claus trapped in the heating system, oozing through the vent covers.
You need to get laid, Ernest. So Ernest and the 80s chick say they're from the governor's office and try to break Santa out.
Now look, I don't know...
I can't tell you what a pet project this is of Governor Ellington's.
Are you sure you're not from the really bad improv group just down the street? So, without checking their ID, they walk into the cell and say they're taking Santa to a mental hospital.
Alright! Was that cool or what? Is this the way government really works? And they bought it!
Thank you, Ernest! I've seen things in there that'll make you turn white Christmas! So Santa explains why it's so important to find Joe and pass the torch onto him.
I've got to make him the next Santa Claus before 7 o'clock tonight. Or, I'm afraid, the magic of Christmas, the joys, the feelings, will be gone forever.
And then all we'll have left is that Jesus fellow, and Lord knows we don't want an entire holiday dedicated to him! That'd be bullshit!
So Ernest disguises himself to find out where Joe is and—
Oh, sweet God!
I'm sure he didn't know you were coming.
Just tell me where he is.
It looks like a bullfrog's ass that got run over, stretched out, run over again, and then inflated.
Your mother must be worried about you.
What?
Well, you've been gone a month now. That's a long time for a girl your age.
Everybody thinks I'm really young, you know, but I'm not. I'm 22.
My mistake.
So I can tap that, then.
No.
So Ernest finds out where Joe is as he puts on yet another disguise to get past studio security.
They're gonna get knotted up on you like that to get real crazy.
Where does he get these outfits anyway? Does he just always have a green dress and pearls in the back of his car? These characters need to ask more questions.
Oh, come to Santa. That's just meta.
So he walks in while Joe is busy shooting a Christmas movie. For the Sci-Fi Channel.
Die!
Joe, I thought this motion picture was called Christmas Slaves.
S-L-A-Y.
What?
It's about an alien from outer space.
It's made by Uwe Boll.
Ah, whoa!
Yeah, I'd hit someone who worked for Uwe Boll too. So Joe agrees to talk to Santa while the airport guys call Animal Control to help with Santa's cargo.
That's not us.
No.
You need air traffic control.
Yeah, air traffic control.
You still can't do it. So the 80s chick replaces Santa's bag with a bag of feathers, and Mr. Lie Detector here can't seem to figure it out until later.
Idiot!
So while she runs away to the train station, Santa visits Joe, who just shaved his beard.
How'd you find my house?
Well, it comes with the job. What did you do to yourself?
No, that's not the question. The question is, how did you find my house?
And what's this supposed to be now? My magic sack of toys?
Look, it's feathers. It's just feathers.
I know it's feathers. I have absolute faith that it will be returned.
Thanks. No thanks.
You have made a powerful enemy today, son.
Now look, I have an appointment to keep.
Yes, I will end you soon enough.
People want to give me more than just, you know, feathers.
Joe, in the end, this does not matter. When you try to pull the fiery pitchfork from hell out of your ass, you will know that my name is the Claws. Merry Christmas, call me.
Meanwhile, some more visitors come in to help Santa out.
We represent the Lollipop Guild, the Lollipop Guild.
I've got to have those reindeer at the Children's Museum like 5 minutes ago, know what I mean?
We've been holding these flea bags for a fella named Elms.
Helper Elves.
You got an ID?
Ta-da!
We're here to shoot a David Lynch film? So Ernest tries to drive the reindeer to the Children's Museum, but gets his tires blown out.
If Santa were here, he'd know what to do.
Oh, yeah? What would he do?
I've got it!
Let's sell the reindeer for another truck! So Ernest gets out the sleigh and they go riding into the night. But the big bad military tries to shoot them down!
Bogey at 9 o'clock!
All passengers, return to your seat!
Keep coming!
You missed, but you can still get Jack Skellington!
Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good...
Good job. So the 80s chick has a change of heart and decides to go back to the Children's Museum. All the while, Joe is ready to sign a deal with the Hollywood people.
These reflect the figures that we discussed.
Before we sign, I need to go over a few problems I have with the script.
Problems.
Problems? What all these problems you speak of?
Can't we do something about the violence and the bad language?
Who do you think you are? You can't sit there and dictate changes to me. You're not some kind of big star, you know. You've been saying please and thank you so much. You've gotten the idea that that's the way things are. Well, get with it, man. This is the real world.
We are Hollywood producers. We are the gods. We are the gods!
So, did you ever find your sack?
Stop calling it that!
Time to open a can.
I got to thinking about you. And Ernest.
And why I look like a female Ralph Macchio. Even Joe sees Santa's sleigh and decides to screw Hollywood and go be jolly old Saint Nick.
How do I look?
Like the real thing.
Guess I better get going.
Where's the sleigh?
Look out! You're gonna run the Superman, turning the world backwards! Ooh, that's a messy Christmas. So Ernest finally gets the sleigh back and Santa allows Joe to take over. They even let Ernest ride the sleigh one more time.
By the way, we haven't been formally introduced. My name is Mary Morrissey.
Well, once upon a time, I was called Seth Applegate. I guess I am again.
It was also called Sindar, Destroyer of Worlds, but that's another time.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas!
Not to me, not to me. Nudge, 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 nudge.
So that was Ernest Saves Christmas. It's stupid, it's cheesy, it doesn't make a whole lot of sense. And I watch it every year. I mean it, it is a serious guilty pleasure. And even though it doesn't totally hold up, there's just some really nice things about it. Mostly centering around that guy who plays Santa Claus, who's just wonderful. And there is just something I really like about it, even if it is phenomenally stupid. Though here's my question in all these movies where they try to prove Santa doesn't exist. If Santa doesn't exist in these worlds, how do they explain the presents just magically appearing under the tree if the parents don't get them? That's what I thought. Merry Christmas, everybody! Thanks for watching all these December episodes. Have a wonderful holiday and... wait a minute. Next month is January. You know what that means! Schwarzenegger month!
Put that cookie down! Cook it down!